Hi again, everybody. Welcome back to the Mac Center, where the Golden Flashes continue this two-game Mid-American Conference homestand. They tonight jumped into first place with an 8-point win over the Miami Redhawks. To the highlights we go.
Hey, sir. Jimmy Hall with a mismatch on a switch with Giovanni on him right off the bat.
Fights against him and scores to put the Golden Flashes in flight on this cold winter's night. 2-0 over Miami on their first three threes. Kent State in transition. That three short. Ortiz flips it up and scores.
I don't know how he made that.
Walker racing away from Mills. Down the lane, hangs, fires, and scores.
Athletic move in transition.
His left comes back right. Walker with five. High bouncer to the block. Ortiz backing in with one to shoot. He beats it. So that's a 14-4 Miami run. This is to try to break a long drought. It does. A three-pointer from Kellen Thomas. The Golden Flashes had gone from Al Cancer near side. And after a quick fake, that three ties the game by Walker. But numbers thwarted. Marvin Jones near side. That's a three. Edwin, he scores. And that's where he throws it into. Right back to Kellen on the block. He'll run it back out. Kent State has a new 30. Kellen right back where he came from. Threads it out to Walker. Another three is up. Another one is in. And in this game against the Miami Redhawks, the first of two. Golden Flashes get a return to form from Jimmy Hall. 18 points for the Golden Flashes sharpshooter on 6-for-10 shooting. He added six rebounds, three assists as well. He was not Kent State's leading scorer. That honor belonged to Kellen Thomas, who, along with his Golden Flashes teammates, hit a bevy of free throws in the second half to keep themselves in the lead. Kellen finished with 19 points, 8 of 11 at the free throw line, four assists for him as well. After the foul, with nearly 7 minutes gone by in the second half. Pollard will come near side and fumbled for the moment by Walker. Got it right back. Throws it away. Then it was deflected underneath. Perfectly planned. Pinball to Chris Ortiz, who slams it home. By two, and Walker near side behind the arc. Plays it back to Xavier. They work it around the perimeter now. It is Pollard in front of us. Throw it down to the block. Hall right around the defender. He scores.
Pretty drop step.
And now they'll slow things up as Kellen brings it into the front court. Feeding Hall. Fakes from beyond the free throw line and awkwardly back out to Kellen for three.
It was awkward.
Not there. Kent State the rebound. A 10-point lead for the Golden Flashes and a transition three. Good. Edwin.
13.
Edwin from his right driving under the basket. Got in the air. One handed out for a Thomas three. Missed it. Edwin the rebound. Put it up. Yep. Golden Flashes again, as I said, for the ballgame, finished 71% from the free throw line and hit free throw after free throw as the game's final 2 minutes almost took a total of a half an hour to play. The Golden Flashes, as time expired, it was all worth it. They win it 76-68. And thanks to a Central Michigan win, they are now tied for first place in the very early going of this year's MAC race. Pivotal third game for the homestand. The Golden Flashes will try to win the rubber match, if you will. The Ohio Bobcats come to town. The Golden Flashes swept the season series from them last year. They'll try to do it again, or at least start it, on Saturday night. Join us at 7 o'clock p.m. on the Golden Flashes home ball game. Now for all of us on Golden Flashes TV, I'm Ty Linder. So long, everybody. Three, two, can you hear? I want to make sure you can hear. We got time, don't you worry. Sandy's going to be in the press conference room in about 20 minutes.